And Byron, as you know, with the road to WrestleMania, every superstar, whether it be Raw, SmackDown Live, 205 Live, begins to up their game a little bit. What do you think we'll see here between Bo Dallas and Sin Cara?
Well, I think the road to WrestleMania is pivotal for superstars like Sin Cara and Bo Dallas, who have a chance to really hit that restart button on their career and start raising some eyebrows around the locker room.
Are you gentlemen feeling inspired right now? Because I'm feeling a little inspired by Bo Dallas.
Are you feeling motivated?
That was awful, Tom.
I have to agree with Austin.
That's something that Bo Dallas has actually said.
Well, Bo Dallas can say it, but you can't.
Okay. And the WWE Universe behind Sin Cara early on here. Former Lucha Dragon alongside Kalisto. Kalisto had an opportunity in the Royal Rumble match, as he found out. A lot of big-time players, a lot of monsters in that match.
Now, without a doubt, one of the most, if not the most, star-studded Royal Rumble in history.
Now, Bo Dallas trying to tie up Sin Cara here in the corner. Oh, and Sin Cara creates a little bit of separation here and takes down Bo Dallas.
Talked with Sin Cara earlier. He's got a lot of friends and family in attendance here tonight. Busted him earlier today. Really should maybe help him with the advantage of almost like a home court advantage, if you will.
The knee right on the side of the face of Sin Cara.
He's going to know the help he can get after that.
The thing we know is Bo Dallas is able to just flip that switch at a moment's notice.
Off the top rope, the spinning neck breaker. Cover here, and Sin Cara able to stay alive. Now another cover, hook to both legs, out of two.
Impressed Sin Cara was able to kick out after that maneuver.
Now Dallas raining down knees. Another cover. And a kick out by Sin Cara. Watch this. Right there, the torque all on the neck.
Dallas had to believe he had Sin Cara defeated here, but wisely maintaining momentum, now trying to wear down Sin Cara.
Austin, would you say you believe in Bo?
I do. I think he's really just a matter of stringing a few victories away to get that momentum he needs. He's had success in the WWE before. He's got the tools to make it happen again.
Former NXT champion, hooked to the leg. Sin Cara able to break free.
Yeah, you know firsthand, Austin, all it takes is that one big win to completely change your mindset. And once you do that, you're right. The sky's the limit.
Exactly, Byron. This game's all about confidence, something that you lack in, frankly. But if you can have that confidence in the ring, that is the deal breaker. That is the thing that will put you over the top. You have to walk out of that curtain with confidence, and Bo Dallas is trying to gain some of that right here tonight.
Speaking of confidence, Sin Cara never had a shortage for confidence in his own right.
And the elbow sends Dallas out. Oh, Sin Cara sending Bo into the barricade.
This will buy Sin Cara some valuable time here to try to recover.
Both men are down outside the ring. Could force a double count out here from the official. Both men after the count of 10 to get back inside the ring. Sin Cara seems to be stirring early on here.
It tells you a lot about Sin Cara. He doesn't want to win this match by count out. He wants to beat Bo Dallas in the middle of that ring.
Veteran here of WWE off the middle rope and a crossbody takes down Dallas.
This is what Bo Dallas has to avoid, letting Sin Cara start to get the momentum going, using his high flying, using those ropes, which he does so well.
And Sin Cara loves to use that ring as a tag team partner.
Once again, off the middle rope, the springboard moonsault. Cover here, kick out by Dallas.
Bolster better start believing that he needs to maybe take a shortcut or two here.
I think he might have hurt you.
Wow.
Impressive strength by Sin Cara.
Sin Cara deceptively strong.
Dumping Bo Dallas, going up to the top rope here. And the senton connects. From the top rope, Sin Cara is dangerous. And he gets the win.
Here's your winner, Sin Cara.
We talk about victories, we talk about momentum. This could be the momentum that Sin Cara needs.
Kevin Owens retaining his WWE Universal Championship against Roman Reigns.
You say retain, I say survive. Kevin Owens got powerbombed through an announce table, got thrown to a stack of steel chairs, and had a lot of help from Braun Strowman.
And walked out still the WWE.
You know, assured Strowman last month that if Owens walked out of Royal Rumble still as champion, then Braun would get a WWE Universal title opportunity. Mick Foley granted Strowman's request for a championship match later in the night. Now, still showing the signs of war from his match against Roman Reigns at the Royal Rumble, Owens made his way to the ring with his best friend, Chris Jericho. However, Jericho took a detour and opted to take a seat at commentary instead of accompanying Owens to ringside. Unfortunately for the United States champ, that decision would put him in a direct path with Strowman. And to eliminate any possibility of outside interference, Strowman would deliver a devastating chokeslam to Jericho through the announce table. Now with no backup and at less than 100%, could Owens retain his WWE Universal title?
If anyone can topple the monster among men, it's Kevin Owens.
Splash to Braun Strowman with the ribs. The ribs, we'll tell you about that in a moment. Here's the cover. Hogan laying in a kick out. And remember, Kevin Owens with a frog splash through Reigns through a table last night. May have injured the ribs. And Owens with a big kick to the face of Strowman. But instead of going down, he actually got back up.
Owens has got to be running on pure adrenaline right now. Taxing his body and his mind, asking himself, how do I topple a monster?
Oh, watch out.
This is it.
Braun Strowman with a power slam. The late, great British. Not on my watch, Strowman. You're not winning the title on my watch, Roman Reigns is saying.
Braun Strowman looks all too willing to repeat history.
Now Braun is daring Roman Reigns. Get inside this ring and fight me.
You know the big dog will never back down from a fight, but in this situation, maybe he should.
Well, here he comes!
Oh, and a Superman punch to Strowman! And that'll be a disqualification, but nonetheless, Roman Reigns has his sights on Strowman. Reigns, the man who eliminated The Undertaker last night.
That just angered Braun Strowman.
Roman Reigns just delivered a Superman punch right to the face of Braun Strowman.
And now Strowman set over the top rope by Reigns.
But Strowman is still on his feet.
Well, Roman Reigns isn't done. Roman Reigns stalking Strowman.
I can't believe Roman Reigns is taking the fight to Braun Strowman like this. Reigns all fired up.
Reigns feels like he has no choice.
What do you mean he has no choice? Byron Roman Reigns interrupted Braun Strowman's championship opportunity.
What about Roman Reigns? Reigns the title last night.
Exactly.
There you go. And Strowman just trying to get away from Roman Reigns here. And Roman Reigns measuring Braun Strowman's spear off the steps. And he takes down the monster of a man.
You mess with my opportunity, I mess with yours.
And a spear to Kevin Owens for good measure.
One versus all, Roman Reigns just laid waste to the WWE Universal Championship match.
Roman's the most disturbing truth that every all-time great has that one opponent that has his number. That every legend has that one asterisk, that every argument that can be made, oh, this is the best ever, has that one argument that counters it that says, yeah, but. Andre the Giant was undefeated for 15 years. Yeah, but then he faced Hulk Hogan at WrestleMania 3. I truly despise, I loathe, I detest, I hold in contempt, I hate, yeah, but! It's the worst thing you can say to a being who lives for his or her accomplishments. Yeah, but tarnishes your legacy. Yeah, but takes away from all you've accomplished. Yeah, but is the argument against Brock Lesnar. Which is why the yeah, but must be eradicated. Yeah, but must be eliminated. Yeah, but must be taken away. Yeah, but must be wiped out. Yeah, but must be killed. Which is why this is the moment where you hit the record button. Ladies and gentlemen, my client, Brock Lesnar, hereby challenges Goldberg one final time at WrestleMania. So here it is, Goldberg. One legend stands over the other. One legacy eclipses the footnote. One conqueror stands over the vanquished victim. Now, any reading of chapter and verse of the biblical story of Goldberg versus Brock Lesnar will tell you the odds are in Goldberg's favor to be the conqueror standing over the vanquished victim, to which my client, Brock Lesnar, offers Goldberg. Yeah, but.
Well, guys, Brock Lesnar's legacy is indeed going to be on the line at WrestleMania if Goldberg accepts the challenge.
Be sour! Clap for your longest reigning tag team champs and feel the power! It's a new day. Yes, it is.
Austin, do me a favor. Let your hips swivel. Let your hands clap and bask in the glory of the power of positivity.
Aries, you don't have to do that.
Byron, you couldn't keep up with me on the dance floor if your life depended on it. You need to go out and buy some rhythm, my friend. My hips, they don't lie.
The following contest is a six-man tag team match scheduled for one fall. Making their way to the ring, the New Day.
Byron, why aren't you out there in the WWE Universe eating up all the Bootios?
Well, you know, I've been trying to get a special request order in to have Bootios here every single week.
And
not working out too well, but I'm still working on it.
The New Day getting ready for six-man tag team action. Are they making snow angels in Laredo, Texas, Austin?
They are. I love it.
Longest reigning tag team champions in WWE history. Well, they're going to face some familiar opponent here in this six-man tag team match.
If you generally haven't tried it yet, I suggest some bananas in your Bootios. It's delicious.
Not too much sugar.
Not for me.
And their opponents, first from Tampa, Florida, weighing 270 pounds, Titus O'Neil.
I almost feel bad for the New Day. They're asking why? They've been trying to get rid of Titus O'Neil for weeks, and this won't go away.
The shining star of the Caribbean.
And his tag team partners, at a combined weight of 440 pounds, Primo and Epico, the shining star.
I actually heard that the New Day bought Titus O'Neil a resort package, hoping he would just stay there.
Wow.
Titus had a great time, was sipping on virgin daiquiri, working on his tan. He said it was the most relaxing week he's had in a long time.
Working on his tan.
Look at it. He looks great tonight, doesn't he?
Titus O'Neil teaming up with the Shining Stars. And while the New Day spent a combined 32 minutes in the Royal Rumble match this past weekend, Titus O'Neil for a long time was actually trying to defeat members of the New Day to get in to said Royal Rumble match.
He tried to defeat members of the New Day. All out wanted to replace the New Day.
Well, he wanted to join the New Day in the beginning. Remember that. Titus O'Neil wanted to be a part of the New Day.
Well, needless to say, nothing has worked.
And then when he couldn't be a part of it, he wanted to destroy the New Day. And then he just tried to take opportunities.
Hey, he gets an A for effort, right?
If you can't join him, beat him.
Xavier Woods to start this thing off against Epico. And Xavier, oh, looking good early. Oh, palm strike right there. Here's the cover and a kick out at two by Epico.
At one point, Titus O'Neil and Shining Stars team up. They're trying to pawn off watches on the Golden Truth.
Oh,
yeah, among many.
Oh,
not the most honorable salesman on the planet.
Look at this teamwork by the New Day. Showing
team.
Why they're the longest reigning WWE champions of all time.
Big E with the splash and a kick out by Epico. That is what made the New Day so dangerous for so long here in WWE. And
you call that throwing shade at Titus?
Well, it's a booty at Titus.
I'll tell you what, the last few weeks, the Shining Stars have been proving they're a dominant tag team. They're a well-oiled machine. But they might be in there with the one
tag team
that's actually more well-oiled than they are.
Oh! Shot to the midsection of Titus O'Neil. And
okay.
What do we got here?
What is this?
Oh. Come on.
There it is.
Come on.
Oh.
Titus can be a little unruly sometimes, so you got to put him in an abdominal stretch. And, well, I guess this is what follows.
The trifecta.
Let's just sit back and enjoy this.
I am.
Oh, the New Day dropping all three members of the opposing team. Are you feeling the positivity, Byron?
I feel it.
My hips are moving, guys.
Here on WWE Main Event, and the New Day have been all over the Shining Stars and Titus O'Neil.
Shining Stars and the Titus brand need to reassess their strategy a little bit.
Epico in there against Xavier Woods, tag made by Titus O'Neil. Not sure if Xavier Woods saw the tag, however.
Uh-oh, knows about it now.
Oh!
That's a long way to fall from, guys. Titus O'Neil's a big boy, he's powerful and he's strong. Not much of a dancer, though.
Now we talked a lot about how Titus O'Neil was trying to get the best of the New Day for a lot of weeks. Man, look at this. I believe Titus is pretty ticked off, was humiliated about the New Day. Ouch! Now looking for the cover here on Xavier to get the win and a kick out.
I guess all that rejection finally got to Titus.
You should know something about that, Byron.
A tag made in comes Primo, and one of the curious moments of the Royal Rumble match, guys, is certainly Sheamus and Cesaro not only eliminating the New Day, but then eliminating each other. It looks like there's some issues between the former tag team champs.
He had to take
cover.
You know, coming into that match, obviously they just lost the tag team title, so there's already built-in frustration, and then losing your opportunity to win the Royal Rumble, I mean, you couldn't be surprised if things virtually imploded.
Listen, the stakes aren't any higher than winning the Royal Rumble match going on the main event WrestleMania, and that can fracture even the best of friends, which Cesaro and Sheamus really would never work.
Xavier Woods trying to reach out to his corner, Big E and Kofi Kingston fresh, but Primo able to shut him down.
Primo reaching for those ropes, reaching there, made the tag.
Stays upright, and in comes Epico, his cousin. Now looking for the cover here and the win in six-man tag team action and a kick out.
Very fluid style of Primo and Epico on display.
Aries, where do you think the Shining Star Resort and Hotel with the Titus brand, how far can it go?
Oh, it could be amazing. Listen, Titus brand, it's about to take off. And Titus is a good spokesman. I think that he could help the Shining Stars draw up a lot of business. Over
wait, how long has the Titus brand been about to take off?
For a while now, but, you know, sometimes, you know.
Sometimes an IPO, just to, you know, go the way they hoped.
The GoFundMe account didn't work.
About that. Xavier Woods trying to reach out here to Kofi Kingston. Fingertip length away and push back into the corner.
Shouldn't have clipped his fingernails before the match. He would have had the tag right there.
And Titus O'Neil.
Oh!
Wow.
Titus got a little pent-up aggression to get out on the New Day.
Now you think?
And just think of what a feather in the cap it would be for him if he could defeat the New Day with the Shining Stars tonight. Who rocking now?
Titus O'Neil saying, who's laughing now? Now rolls Xavier into the ring. The cover here in Woods, still in this match.
He starts dancing again, the whole arena will be laughing, but right now he's thrilling in control.
Handful of hair, Titus O'Neil still talking trash.
Does Titus ever stop talking trash?
That's a good point.
Oh, and a jawbreaker there by Xavier Woods.
Now he will.
Can he create a big enough opening? Big E and Kofi Kingston reaching in, and Titus takes a shot at E.
Smart strategy by Titus.
I thought he was going somewhere. Right on the side of the face.
Sometimes you can talk too much.
Titus thinks he's back at the Shining Star Resort right now, sipping on a daiquiri.
Or the University of Florida. Kofi Kingston badly wants the tag. Xavier Woods with an opportunity here.
Almost there.
Reaching out. Here comes Kofi. Tyrone takes down Primo.
We'll be trying to change the tone of this match.
Kofi Kingston just a ball of energy.
Oh, caught himself on the middle rope. Oh, and a crossbody onto Primo. Hook to the leg here, and the New Day all so close.
Ridiculous agility, too.
Oh, shot to the throat there, looked like by Primo. Kofi Kingston takes him down.
Kofi's feeling it.
And Kofi with the New Day boom drop. Hold on, Epico stirring it, taking off the apron.
Kofi looking on top of his game here.
Oh, SOS! This could be it for the Shining Swords. Oh, Titus Titus broke it up. Oh, belly to belly.
Oh, watch out, Big E.
Oh, went for the backstabber there. Big E able to catch himself.
Xavier on the move.
Oh, a shining wizard there from Woods. There's a backstabber for you.
Really keep up with this.
That's breaking down here. I don't know who that favors.
He's back to the two original legal men. And Kofi in the corner. Oh, gets the boot up in time. I believe Big E made the tag. The official signals it. Oh, boy.
Big trouble.
See you, Primo. Midnight hour. And the New Day rocks here on Main Event.
Here are your winners, the New Day.
I think Aries has found that swivel in his hips you were talking about.
There we go, Austin.
I can't help it every time I hear their music.
It consumes you.
Absolutely not knowing Titus O'Neil. I know.
It is all about New Day here tonight on Main Event.
Seth freaking Rollins. The man I plucked from obscurity and made a star, handed him the world. I sang his praises, and he became the first NXT champion. Ironic, isn't it? He would go on to be the leader of the Shield. And then I would make him an offer to be the best. And he bought in, and he bought in a big way. And standing by my side, Seth Rollins would become the man. Standing by my side, Seth Rollins would become the face of the WWE. Standing by my side, Seth freaking Rollins would become the WWE World Heavyweight Champion. Standing by my side, Seth Rollins would get everything he ever wanted out of this business and more. And all he had to do, all Seth Rollins had to do, was hold up his end of the bargain. And he couldn't do it, could he? No. As soon as the pressure got to be too much, as soon as the pressure mounted, he collapsed under the weight of it. His leg gave way, and then he came in this ring, and he stood here with tears streaming down his face, and he stood and he held out that world championship, and he handed it back, and he handed back everything that I had ever handed him on a silver friggin' platter, and he spit in my face. He spit in my face, and then he hobbled up that ramp into obscurity. And he thought he was just gonna come back here later, as if the world didn't turn without Seth Rollins. Only the world did turn. And 7 months later, when Seth Rollins stood in this ring without me by his side, Seth friggin' Rollins was an abject failure. Seth Rollins was a massive failure. And did he take any responsibility for that failure? No. That failure was blamed on me. I was the reason that Seth Rollins failed. I am supposed to apologize to Seth Rollins, but I don't feel like I owe Seth Rollins an apology. If anything, I am the one that is owed an apology. I gave you the world, Seth Rollins, and you spit in my face. You have any idea, all of you, any idea how hard it is for me, not to come to this ring when Seth Rollins stands out here and calls me out? I don't come out here because my wife asked me not to. And she's right, because it's what's best for business that I don't. Because I am trying, whether anybody wants to believe it or not, I am trying so hard not to be that guy anymore. I am trying so hard not to be that guy that ends careers and crushes dreams and injures people and doesn't give a crap about anybody or what anybody thinks. I am trying so hard not to be that guy anymore, to be something more. So every day I put on this suit. Every day I tie this stupid tie and I go to the office. And every day I try to put that behind me and I try to be a creator. I try to create something more for everybody here. And then a guy like Seth Rollins decides he wants to come to NXT. Seth Rollins wants to come where I am trying to create, where quite honestly, I am trying to create the next Seth friggin' Rollins. So I am done trying. I am so done trying. So here's the thing, Seth freaking Rollins. You don't have to worry about coming to my house because I am standing right here, right now. You already know who your creator is. Well then, Seth Rollins, get your ass to this ring and meet your destroyer.
Triple H calling out Seth Rollins. Seth said earlier he has nothing left to lose. It's only once you've lost everything that you're free to do anything. Rollins had better be ready to do anything.
Yeah, the man who says he will slay the king, Seth Rollins.
There is no turning back now.
The moment Rollins has waited for months is upon us. Triple H waiting in the ring. Seth Rollins staring down at the game.
See it in his eyes. Seth Rollins' blood is boiling. It's about to go down.
And Triple H seething as well. These two massive egos about to collide here on Monday Night Raw.
Seth is going to...
Samoa Joe, and now Triple H just walks away.
Wow.
He's going to allow Samoa Joe to do the damage, to inflict the punishment as Rollins tries to fight back.
Triple H never laid a hand on Rollins.
Samoa Joe's laying plenty of hands on Rollins, and his feet and a senton. Samoa Joe, one of the baddest human beings.